In the back, I'm just curious, since Twilight fans are so rabid, what's been your craziest fan encounter? And after that, please tell us what you've got in mind next.
Craziest fan encounter. That is so tough to, like, choose one. I don't like using the word crazy. I like using the word passionate. So, I mean, Krista and I had a very interesting Brazil experience that I've talked about numerous times that just was out of control, but amazing, and there was a lot of passion there. And then I've had a few girls that, I mean, you know, tattoo a picture of you or your signature to their arm. I mean, that's just, that blows my mind. Something new happens every single day, and it continues to blow my mind. Like, you think we would all get used to it and expect it, but every time something happens, we're like, are you kidding me? I mean, it's just, we wouldn't be here today, you know, promoting a fourth movie if it wasn't for that amount of passion. So, I mean, that's absolutely unreal to me. And then next, I don't know, to be honest. I've been promoting back-to-back movies, or two back-to-back movies, and now I'll have a little break, which I'm excited for, and it'll give me time to, you know, catch up on sleep a little bit, and also start to think what'll be next.
What about Gus Van Sant?
What about him? He's,
Wasn't that just announced this week that you're going to do a movie with him?
He is a very, very talented director who I've always looked up to, and I've always wanted to work with. It's very premature, so I really don't have much to say now, other than the fact that I really, really respect him and would love the opportunity to work with him.
Is it true that it's based in a New Yorker article?
There is a project like that floating around somewhere on this planet.
Hi, Taylor. Hi. Now that you've finished playing Jacob, is there any part of the character that will stick with you?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, after playing the same character for 5 movies and for years, you grow so close to him. And, I mean, you start putting yourself into Jacob, and you start putting Jacob into you. And, I mean, I love Jacob. I mean, there's many things that I look up to Jacob for. So, I mean, Jacob's one of the most loyal people, one of the most persistent people. He has amazing qualities to him that I hope I can learn from him and implement into my own life, which is kind of cool.
Back here, Taylor,
way in the back.
How are you doing? Following on what you were saying about what's coming next, and also the prospects of whether it's working with Gus Van Sant or doing a variety of films, how important is it to you now, being so identified? Not that there's anything wrong with being part of a hugely successful franchise, but being so identified with Jacob and this particular story, how important is it to you to find something different, or is it just a matter of finding something that keeps your face out there?
No, it's definitely not a matter of just finding something that keeps your face out there. It's I mean, I want everything to feel special to me, and I'm very specific about that. But no, I mean, in a way, it would almost, and we've all said this to each other, because we all deal with it, it would almost be a compliment to be typecast, because that's our jobs. Our jobs are to make the fans believe that we are these characters. So in one sense, we're trying to do that to ourselves, because that's the goal with these fans. But at the same time, of course, as actors, we want to be able to go off and do different things and challenge ourselves to many different roles. So yeah, it is... It's very exciting in one sense that it's coming to an end, and we get to go off as actors and experience different things and continue to challenge ourselves and grow. But at the same time, it's a bummer because it's been such a huge part of our lives.
Taylor, one of your most pivotal scenes, when you kind of fight back as a wolf and kind of go alpha a little bit, is done in the heads of the wolves. So it's not... Did that kind of frustrate you that you couldn't put your own physicality to that, or did you guys rehearse it as people standing there at some point? Did you just have to do it in an empty room? And
we actually, yeah. It was kind of weird and awkward because we were standing in an empty room.
Okay.
And they actually filmed us. So we actually did a version of that scene.
Oh, okay.
And I, you know, they filmed us just because, you know, we said all of the lines, and you know, that was the voice that's used in the movie. But at the same time, like when we're filming that scene, if my face does something, they would implement that into the wolves. So it's very, very cool the amount of detail that they pay attention to. So in a way, yeah, I'm bummed because the wolves got a very cool scene that we did. But I'm kind of used to that by now. You know, we were able to do the scene, and they actually were able to use specific things that we did with our bodies, with our faces, with our voice, with everything, and just implemented them into the wolf.
Hi, Taylor. You said a few minutes back that you guys could not have done this without Bill, made these two films. Are you comfortable enough this late in the franchise, or feel maybe that you own the role enough to say to him or to whoever, no, Jacob wouldn't have done it that way, he would have done it this way? And did you get into any kind of situations where you were arguing for your take on it?
Thankfully, no. I mean, we are so open with each other that, you know, I'm sure any of us would have spoken up and said that, but with Bill, he just made us feel so comfortable to begin with, because it could have been a challenge playing, you know, the same character for 5 movies, and you have a different director each time, and then when the new director comes on board, sometimes it can take a second to adjust and get on the same page with them. But Bill was so amazing, and he really just made us feel comfortable and open. A version of those did happen where, it wasn't an argument, but we would say, you know, I think he would do this, or I think he would say this, or I don't think he would do that. And Bill was very open about everything, and then Bill would, you know, he would say the same stuff to us. And I mean, I've respected Bill for a very long time, even before I've, you know, had the opportunity to work with him or found out I was going to be able to work with him. So I was able to completely trust him. All of us were, which was very important as well.
Last question, please.
Taylor over here. Can you understand why Jacob will just not let Bella go, so guys would just be like, okay, fine, you're married now? And also, can you talk about your very last scene that you ever filmed as
Mm-hmm. I go back and forth with Jacob's persistence. I mean, most of the time, yeah, I can understand it. Because there's been things in my life that I have wanted so much, and when you're told no, you gotta keep going. You gotta go for it, because, you know, if you're told no, you just say, oh, okay, and give up. I mean, I wouldn't be sitting here today. It requires a lot of hard work and a lot of persistence. And if you believe in something, if you love something, you got to go for it no matter what. So most of the time I could relate, but yeah, there's moments where I'm just like, dude, you've got to get over it. Like, she's married now. She's on honeymoon. It's about time to move on. There are a few of those moments. Our last scene was tough, because I knew filming the last scene was going to be tough, but it was more emotional for all of us than we expected, and it didn't help that my very last scene was with Kristen. It was with Rob as well, but he comes in at the end and breaks it up. But it's really it's a last dance between Bella and Jacob towards the end of their wedding, and it's really, you know, Jacob is saying goodbye to Bella. She's off to her honeymoon, and he's kind of realizing that it's over. Everything I've been working for is over, and it's really time for him to move on and realize that. So it's an emotional scene, and we're like saying goodbye to each other pretty much, and that was the very last scene we filmed together. So it didn't help the situation. And I remember when we finished, and you know, Chris and I just looked at each other. I don't think we really had anything to say, because the emotion from the scene was overwhelming us, and then the emotion of the situation on top of that, it was tough, but it was a very special moment, and now when I watch that scene, I have a lot of great memories.